Hola, bienvenidos a tu curso. El subjuntivo para principiantes, the subjunctive for beginners. Now, you might be thinking, what is Gordon talking about? The subjunctive for beginners. But beginners don't learn the subjunctive, do they? In fact, it's only when you get to an upper intermediate or advanced level that you start to learn the subjunctive. And that's true. And it's completely wrong. It's a big mistake. And let me explain what I mean by that. As a beginner, and when I say a beginner, look, you know, you could be an absolute beginner. You could be getting up to the advanced beginner or an early intermediate or advanced intermediate. It doesn't really matter. I'm calling this course Subjunctives for Beginners because it's a message that I want to give. And the message is that please don't wait until you are years down the line before you start to look at the subjunctive. Why? Let me explain what happens. I've seen this over and over and over again. I have seen people who have a really good level of Spanish. These are people who aren't Spanish speakers, but have a really good level of Spanish. And they've got everything under control, the past, the present, the future, all of the perfect tenses. And yet, there's this big gaping hole in their subjunctive use. They don't use it. In fact, I saw somebody who was fluent in Spanish, and they had no present subjunctive at all. They used the past subjunctive, they just didn't use the present. So how can that happen? What goes on? Well, what goes on is this, simply. When you're learning Spanish, you are creating habits. You are creating neural pathways in your brain, okay? And every time that you say your sentence like, voy a ir a España, okay? Voy a ir a España. Every time that you say that, you are cutting a new neural pathway in your brain. Your brain is saying, okay, I know how to say, I am going to Spain, okay? And so the more that you say it, the more that pathway gets cut into your brain. It's like, imagine a field of corn and somebody is walking across the cornfield. Now they could walk across the field and pretty much you wouldn't notice it the first time. But if they do that 100 times, suddenly there's going to be a pathway cut into that field. Well, that's what happens the more that you repeat and you repeat. So what happens is this, if you repeat the wrong thing, your brain doesn't care. It takes it as that's the way that it's said. So when you say, for example, a simple sentence like, I hope they come. Yeah, I hope they come. Now that's not an advanced sentence. That's just a beginner sentence, isn't it? But if you don't know that that's a trigger for the subjunctive, then you're going to say, espero que vienen. And you're going to feel very good about yourself. Except it's wrong. It's espero que vengan. But how do you know? When do you know how to use the subjunctive? Well, that's what this course is all about. My advice to you is don't wait until it's too late. Don't wait until you've formed loads of habits. Because then, when you come to actually install the subjunctive, which happens in the most simple present tense sentences, then you're in problems because you've already got your cornfield marked, you've already got your pathway marked. And so every time you try to use the subjunctive, your mind's going to say, no, this is how we say it. Does that make sense? You get into bad habits, and then it's a real bugger to get out of those bad habits. Unfortunately, that's just the way it is. So this course is designed for you so that you get into good habits right at the beginning. And I promise you that if you work through this course and you start to get into good subjunctive habits, and I'm going to help you with that. I'm going to show you the easiest way of doing it that I know. Then as you advance in Spanish, you will use the subjunctive beautifully and easily, and it will be a natural process. If you don't, and you learn Spanish without the subjunctive, it's very difficult then to put it in afterwards. Okay, so that's why I'm calling this course Subjunctive for Beginners. That's all. It isn't that you have to be a beginner, but let's get it done now. Let's not wait. It isn't that difficult, I promise you. So this course is going to be looking at the present tense. All right, why? Because this is a subjunctive for beginners. Okay, we're just going to learn how to use the subjunctive in the present. And then there'll be another course which will help you with the past when you're more advanced, and that's fine. Okay, so ponte el cinturón de seguridad, buckle up, porque vamos a tener una aventura en el mundo del subjuntivo. We're going to have an adventure in the subjunctive world. I'll see you in the next video.